Please make a Solus review, is one of the most frequent requests I get. Solus 4 has just been released and I had to review it. But I'm not going to show you what's new in Solus 4. Instead, I will show you pros and cons of this distribution and explain why some of you would better use other Linux distro. The first question, which I think is worth starting with, what is Solus OS? First of all, Solus is a distribution on its own. In other words, it is not based on any other Linux distro. This already makes Solus pretty unique and interesting. Second, it is a rolling distribution. As it is said on the Solus website, install today, update forever. Given these two statements, it is natural to look at Solus Sol. By Sol, I mean its package manager and its graphical interface, the software center. Solus has its own package manager, which, as I have found out, was forked from Pardus Linux. You probably even don't know what Pardus Linux is, but I know it pretty well, because it was my main Linux distro in 2011. Pardus Linux is a Turkish distribution that is now focused on business only, but back in 2011, it came from nowhere and became very popular. One of the reasons was that it was the most stable Linux distro with KDE 4 desktop environment at that time. I really enjoyed using it. I was very happy with Pardus package manager and the software center. And my experience with Pardus makes me quite confident in Solus. I have not tested the Solus package manager and the software center extensively, but installing around 15 programs and running a couple of updates went very smoothly. There are many pros in this package manager and the software center. Although Solus is a rolling distro and handling packages in a rolling distro is not easy, the Solus package manager does it pretty well. The software center is also impressively fast. It opens quickly, navigation within it is also fast. I would say Solus software center is one of the fastest graphical package managers in Linux. In addition to the most popular standard Linux applications, it offers a set of third-party apps. You can install Google Chrome, Skype, Spotify, just with one click from here. I was also surprised to find here Mendeley, which is my favorite reference manager in Linux. Definitely, I give a like to Solus for that in particular and for its software center in general. Nevertheless, I have to mention some cons too. First, I find it confusing to search for packages within the software center. You cannot search from anywhere. You need to navigate to the search tab and search here. Also, when you enter the application info page, and let's say you decided to search for another application, clicking on the search does nothing. You actually need to click on the back button. To me, it was really annoying. Also, I was not able to search only within the installed packages. To see if an app is installed, you need to enter its page. This is too complicated in my opinion. But I believe the Solus team is working on its software center and its search will be improved. Second, Solus is written from scratch and it is a relatively new distro, so don't expect to find all programs in its repository. If you need some less popular programs, you will have to install them manually. For example, I use some of these molecular biology related programs for Linux. But none of them is available in the software center of Solus, while many of them are easily accessible in the Debian repository, for example. If you also need some specific programs in your Solus, be ready for some shaman dance while compiling and installing them. The third point I would like to talk about is budget desktop and the Solus themes. Yeah, Solus is written from scratch, and its desktop is not exception. Budgie is a desktop written specifically for Solus distro. Though it is now available in many Linux distros, including Ubuntu Budgie, Manjaro, Arch Linux. Budgie is based on some of GNOME technologies, and it still uses some of its apps, like system settings, calendar, and others. However, I am sure the Solus team is working on creating its own applications for everything. They just need time. Actually, the budget desktop is probably the number one reason many users get attracted to Solus. It is a modern and beautiful desktop indeed. In particular, I like its applets and notification bar. It is very handy to have a quick access to some features here, like for example output devices. Here I can quickly change between my speakers and headphones. I have to use a specific widget for that in my Plasma 5 desktop, but in Budgie it is provided by default. I do appreciate that. There is a dedicated settings window to tweak your Budgie desktop. It provides only basic settings, but it should be enough for 90% of users. For example, I personally usually have the desktop panel on the left instead of the bottom, and Budgie allows me to move the panel to the side without losing any functionality of the panel. This setting should be enough for many users, but I personally like more customization, but it is my personal taste of course. Speaking about the negative side, I would also complain about the themes. I personally don't like this default dark theme, it is too dark. The light theme provided by default is not good either. The windows look good, but the panel color is not right at all. The only usable theme here is Plata Lumine Compact. This is really sad, because previous versions of Solus had much better default themes. And I think that the old theme was one of the main reasons many users tried Solus. Finally, KDE applications look alien in Budgie. You are probably not supposed to install KDE apps in Budgie desktop, but what if I cannot live without KDE in life for video editing? Moreover, it is not only KDE apps that have some problems. Audacity looks little unusable with the default theme. I was not able to see what options were selected here. After I changed the theme to Plata Lumine Compact, it became a little better, but still not perfect. I'm not sure who to blame here, either Budgie desktop or Audacity design, but there is a problem here, as you can see. Of course, one can change the themes by installing additional themes, but it requires extra steps. I think I will cover that in the next video, things to do after installing Solus. If you want to see such a video, give this video a like and subscribe if you're not subscribed yet. Installation and performance. I installed Solus the day it was released. The installation process was standard and smooth. I really liked the Solus installer. It provided all options I needed, including manual partition assignment and excluding the bootloader from the installation process. Because I installed this Solus along my Arch Linux and I wanted to keep my group bootloader from my Arch Linux system, which is my main system. If you watched my Manjaro review, you probably remember I had some problems with dual booting Manjaro and Arch Linux. No issues with Solus on this side. So only positive impressions from the installation. Next, I tested Solus for a week. I just performed my regular tasks, and Solus was installed on my home machine, which I do not use extensively. But I can say, for a regular desktop use, Solus works very well. It is not a light desktop. Here is its resource usage right after I log in. But on my system with Intel Core i3, 8GB of RAM and an SSD, it worked fine. I have not had any single lag or a slowdown. I also unintentionally tested the suspend function. I never suspend my desktop, but Solus suspends the system by default if it is idle for 20 minutes. I left my computer on for a couple of times and it was suspended several times without a reboot. And every time it woke up quickly without issues. So if you use suspend, it works brilliantly in Solus. Thus, the installation and performance of Solus are great. Before I continue to the next point of this review, I would like to make a small announcement. I hope you have heard about Article 13. If you haven't, Google it. To make a long story short, this article means that small YouTubers like me might not be able to upload to YouTube anymore. And if this happens, you will lose access to my content. But don't worry, to save you and save me, I encourage you to move to my website, averagelinuxuser.com. So you can go to this website right now and subscribe for the updates. Or in case if something happens to YouTube, you always know where to look for me. Thank you and let's go to the next point. As a final point of this review, I would like to talk about Solus community. I believe having a community around a distro is very important, especially for new users. Solus has a very active forum, where you can get help within a few hours. Since version 4, you can also get help through Hex Chat app, that is installed by default. I do not have personal experience with Solus community, but I monitor what users say in social media, and I have seen only positive feedback. Although Solus is a young distro, there is already a large community to rely on. Also, before you ask for any help, check out the Solus Help Center. Maybe you will find a solution there. To summarize this review, I would like to list all the pros and cons of Solus. Solus is a worthy distro because it is a rolling distro. It has a great package manager and fast software center. All commonly used open source and third-party programs are available. Budget Desktop provides a unique experience of a modern desktop. Solus is overall fast, stable, and reliable. There is a supportive community. However, if you want to install Solus as your main Linux distro, consider these cons. Many specific programs are not available in the repository and will require compilation and manual installation. Solus 4 is a little unlucky with its default theme, so you may need to install some additional themes by yourself. Some programs may not look nice in Budgie, like KDE apps. Also, it is not a light desktop. I hope these pros and cons will help you to make a decision whether to install Solus or some other Linux distro. If you have something to add to these lists, please comment below. Thank you for watching.